train went off the rails and then hit another. It happened at the height of rush hour on one of the nation's busiest routes from New York's Grand Central Station to Boston. ABC's Marcy Gonzalez tonight on the critical injuries and the relief that the outcome wasn't far worse.
24 hours after two commuter trains packed with passengers collided in Connecticut, the twisted wreckage remains. Our ABC News camera, the only one right there as NTSB investigators took a first look, saying it could be weeks before they know why this happened.
We will not be determining the probable cause of the accident while we're here on scene, nor will we speculate on what may have caused the accident.
What they can say is this crash could have been much worse. It was the height of the Friday evening rush when a Metro North train left New York City, passing near Bridgeport, Connecticut, when it somehow derailed. Its center cars then leaning directly into the path of an oncoming train on the adjacent tracks.
It was one of those kind of jolts that really sent people flying.
Of the 700 people on board those trains, 70 were hurt. Senator Richard Blumenthal says that number would likely be higher if not for the new rail cars put in operation 2 years ago.
Perhaps injuries were avoided because these are better cars.
Tonight, 8 people remain in the hospital, 3 in critical condition. And David, we're told it could be days before these trains are finally moved, which would also mean headaches for thousands of commuters here in the Northeast as they try to make their way to work on Monday morning.